Elephas Maximus. One lovely autumn afternoon, my auntie took me to the zoo. She asked me, "Would you like the chance to see a giant gracefully dance? The largest living animal on land, the biggest of the big, I mean really grand." "Yes, please," I said, with a nod of my head. "Right, then off we go," my auntie said. "I wonder what color," I started to say. "Of the animal?" she asked. I nodded. "Oh, pale, light gray." "And auntie, what does it eat, and how does it walk? And how does it sound when it wants to talk? And how does it gather its food to eat, and what is the shape of its tail, its feet? And auntie, does it have babies or eggs that will hatch? And who is the predator that will try to catch?" "Your questions are good. Your thoughts are profound," said auntie. And then we heard a fierce trumpeting sound. "Come up this way," my auntie motioned. And then I saw what had made the commotion. For standing large, in imposing presence, in answer to all my many questions, right there before us with long white tusks, stood perfectly splendid Elephas Maximus. His elephant back was raised like an arch, and he lifted his feet in a rhythmic march. Compared to the rest, his tail looked like a string, but his trunk, ah, his trunk, what a wonderful thing! It was long and strong with almost a finger at the tip for picking at things I saw as I lingered. Leaves and roots off the tops of the trees he reached for and got without stretching his knees. And then, with his mighty trunk's finger-like tip, he slurped at the water he drank in a sip, as if through a straw by sucking it up, then squirted the drink in his mouth with no cup. Auntie says a trunk is handy to tell things that an elephant needs to know well, the shape and the feel and the cold and the hot, and whether he'd like to eat something or not. His trunk reached to his feet that were giant like trees, and his ears flapped happily in the breeze. Between his ears, I counted 1, 2 bumps on his forehead, and then, to know more, on his cage sign I read, "This Asian or Indian elephant is smaller than its cousin, the African elephant. Why, he's taller, with huge ears and long tusks, with a 10-foot span. That other is Loxodonta africana. But the thing that I will most remember from my elephant visit at the zoo in September is that the tusks on Elephas Maximus were longer than my auntie is tall, and that I felt very, very small."